Arr. I'm kitchening, let me take these off. Oh. It's the 15th of December, and it's one of those days. Been up and down most of the night, not sleeping well, uncomfortable, in pain, pressure in my stomach, pain with my spine. Now 1:43, 1:45, and I've still got my PJs on underneath my wrap, my oxygen line around me so it doesn't pull too much around my ears. My head is screaming, my eyes hurt. Got tinnitus so loud I can barely hear my thoughts. So with this issue with my stomach, I feel like there's pressure around my, just around my sternum area, and I kind of like fluttering kind of thing going on, pulsating thing going on. So last night I started with the peppermint and fresh ginger tea, which I still have some going there. Made myself a strong cup of coffee. Not often I drink coffee anymore, so we'll see what happens with that. Then the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fix up myself bone broth. In the fridge. You saw that, didn't you? That happens quite often with the oxygen line. So I have some, this is actually, oh, I won't shake it too much. This is actually bone broth, turkey bone broth, vegetable soup, but with my stomach being the way it is, I mean, you can see it's separated. There was the clear broth at the top, and then there was all the goodness in the bottom. Now if you want, you can separate it out and have it that way if you want a clear liquid diet, but I'm gonna try it this way because I'm trying to keep my nutrients up. So I'm just gonna pour this. I'm gonna try and get the video for this up. Actually, no, the video I think is already up. I have to check, but if it is, I'll put the thing up here for you to check it. Okay. There's something I call the wall. And a lot of people I know will understand this, not just people with chronic illness, but people who are constantly on the go, have days, and I mean, it could be once a month, once a week, I mean, whatever, it just is different for each person, where they just hit this wall where their body says, no go, not going any further. I'm gonna, this is, a lot of this is the marrow out of the bone, because I did crack some of the bones, the bigger bones, to help get the marrow out, and some of the smaller bones actually did cook down completely. Okay, I will pause you while I do this, and my head is not going to thank me for it at all. I feel right nauseous right now. Okay, back. Okay, so I blended it all down, mushed it all up, and broke it all down, so my digestive system has less work to do. I'm going to add some more water to this to thin it down a little bit so it's not so rich and thick. And then got my hand at old soup cup. And this is what I shall be eating off. Okay, lift it all the way up, June, then you can get it off. And this is what I'll be eating off throughout the day and evening. Now, for hubby, for his food, there's times when I'm like this, he'll cook his own stuff. Veggies already chopped up, prepared. And oh god, go on, throw it all over you. I just don't want it to separate too much before I pour it in the jar. Okay, I'm gonna put half this in the jar. There's enough there for another quart jar. Top it up with water. Not that you all really needed to see this process, but hey. And as you can see, it's still quite rich and thick. I'm going to warm it up. And yes, I'm going to warm it up in the microwave. Because that's the quickest, easiest thing to do right now. Probably too noisy, but never mind. And then I shall add a little bit of plain yogurt to that. When I've taken it out. This in the top of the fridge. I use greaseproof paper between the ring and the jar so that way the ring doesn't get weird. And I'm not wasting a canning jar, because this doesn't get canned, it goes in the fridge. Oh, the fridge is cold enough, and this doesn't last that long in the fridge. It gets eaten fast, because it gets eaten every day. And the dishwasher is a good place to store your jars once they've been washed and sterilized. Now top that up with some water, and there you go, that's 2 quarts made out of a quart. Now I have some I have quinoa. I have quinoa already prepared, so just to add a little bit of variety to my soup during the day, or during the evening, afternoon and evening, I should say, I can drop in a little bit of quinoa that's already prepared. Did you know that you can do relief patterns with greaseproof paper? Should do a video on that one day. Looks pretty neat. And I'm then going to go back to bed. Because I'm lucky in my hospital bed sits now. I have a hospital bed, so the top end comes up. And I will be doing some work with my new tablet, my new graphics tablet. And probably edit some more videos and maybe put some more videos up. But remember, one step at a time, one breath at a time, I can do this. I love you all. Take care.